staging يعني حتى beyond the surgical stage they present for like advanced disease and they present for palliative chemo radiation and the reason because they do lack the screening and they do lack also what you call it, the vaccination now. So in general we know that the higher the cases of precancerous changes, the lower the incidence of cervical cancer. Meaning, once you have a screening, you have a vaccination, you're going to detect precancerous changes, what we call a cervical dysplasia. And we know that cervical dysplasia got a long preclinical stage, which is up to 10 years till it becomes a cancer, okay? So now we know that because of the vaccine, because of the well-organized screening programs, usually you may decrease the incidence of cervical cancer and lowering that. Like in North America, it's number 13 or 14 or 15 even. It ranks like less and less compared to the developing countries. Developed countries, they have like a lower rate or incidence. We know that the vaccine is there now. We have three types of vaccines. We have what we call it the bivalent vaccine, and we have the quadrivalent vaccine, and we have Gardasil 9. We're going to talk about the vaccine, different types, regimens, etc. We know that HPV vaccine is a prophylactic vaccine. It is not a therapeutic vaccine, okay? And we have to know the false positive and false negative for the pap smears. False positive is only 5%. So if you have a positive pap smear, you don't think this is mostly false positive. However, the false negative is 50%. The predictive value is very 50-50. And we know this is the best of what we have. So you want to look for a screening program where a test where it got the highest sensitivity and the highest specificity. And this is the pap smear, it's only 50%. And we know that sensitivity is the positive test among the positives, اللهم affected. And specificity is the negative test among the negatives. اتذكروا الكلمة هذه عمركم ما تنسوا ايش الديفينيشن حق specificity والsensitivity. Sensitivity, the positive test among the positives, اللي هم الناس اللي هم affected. Negative test is the negative test among, specificity is the negative test among the negatives, اللي هو patients who do not have the disease. So we know that the HPV has many, many strains. لو رميت أي رقم في الإكزام, you should be correct. Nobody knows exactly all the numbers. We know that almost 100 strains affecting humans. Patient with suppressed immunities, post-transplant, on steroids, HIV patients, smokers, pap test history, this is a very important factor in the cervical cancer. Most of the patients with cervical cancer, they never had a pap smear in their life. Sexual history, we know that multiple partners. In the kingdom, here we have cross marriage, like واحد مزوج اثنين ثلاثة, but they take it from each other. And we know that pap test, this is a pap test. We have two types. We have the liquid-based cytology, which is the conventional cytology and liquid-based cytology. The conventional is the one on the left. This is the old way, and this is the liquid-based cytology. It is superior for sure because it gives us many controlled cellular density. Usually there is a universal distribution of the cells itself. The most important part is you can do HPV testing from that, and you can see clearly the nuclear changes. What we worry about the diagnosis of cervical dysplasia is nuclear changes. And this is what we call it cervical dysplasia, meaning you look at the nucleus, you're gonna find dysplasia, meaning there is hyperchromatidism, there is increased nucleocytoplasmic ratio, there is multiple micronuclei. This is all dysplasia. So when you do a liquid-based cytology, it is superior. It is more sensitive, and we can see here, this is the conventional, very busy slides with many leukocytes, inflammatory cells. We don't know which one is the nucleus, this one or this one or this one, right? But if you go to the liquid-based cytology, you can tell. This is where you can see the nuclear details. And you can have the acidophilic and this and basophilic. Basophilic is the yellowish, acidophilic is even the cytologist, they can tell which day or if the cycle the patient is in, menstrual cycle. So questions on when to start screening, according to the latest recommendation, at the age of 21 or 3 years of sexual life beyond the age of 21. يعني المريضة لو كانت sexually active by the age of 15, you don't do it before the age of 21 or 20, because the likelihood of cervical cancer is very low. And remember also, when we do the screening, we do it every 3 years for low-risk patients, we do it every year for high-risk patients. But remember, there is pap smear, and there is what we call it co-testing. Co-testing meaning you bring the patient, you do a pap smear, and at the same time you check for HPV if she is positive or not. This is co-testing. It gives you more confidence that the patient is negative, so you can space your screening every 5 years. So if you do only pap smear, you do repeat it every 3 years for average risk patients. If you are gonna do it with the co-testing, remember co-testing and there is reflex testing, it's a completely different like entities. So co-testing meaning you're gonna do it at the same time, you can space it every 5 years. Frequency, as we said, every 3 years, but you do it every year for the high risk group. When to stop screening, there is no guidelines, but most of the screening, they do stop it by 70, the like North American. By 70, it's very unlikely if the patient had a normal pap smears in the past to grab it like with a new partner. Screening for high-risk patients, it's more frequent every year. Post-hysterectomy, if somebody asks you, your question should be, what was the indication for hysterectomy? She had it for like postpartum hemorrhage, for myomas, endometriosis. This is benign. You don't need to do it, right? But if the patient had it for any, she had a hysterectomy, I mean, for any genital dysplasia, meaning cancer of the cervix or the uterus or whatever, you have to continue doing it every year. So if somebody asks you after hysterectomy, what do? You ask him, what is the indication or what was the indication of the hysterectomy? Okay, this is an important slide. We know that the cervix has ectocervix and has endocervix. So ectocervix, which is squamous cell carcinoma, squamous cell, which is similar to the vagina. And then we have endocervix, which is columnar, which is similar to the endometrium. So endocervix, glandular, columnar will give you adenocarcinoma. Ectocervix is squamous, which give you a squamous cell carcinoma. Sorry. So always remember the origin of the cells tells you where to go and how to investigate for different dysplasias or different cancer. We know that the normal cervical length is 4 centimeters. So if you want to sample the endocervix, we call it endocervical curettage, ECC. Endocervical curettage, you should not go with your curette more than 4 centimeters because the cervical length is usually 4 centimeters. So remember, endocervix and ectocervix. So this is like universal standard, what you call it, reporting system for the pap smears. Like you have to have squamous cells abnormalities and we have adeno or columnar cells abnormalities, meaning you should have ASCAS or you should have ASCH or you should have low grade or high grade or squamous cell carcinoma. So if you got any other reporting from your cytologist, you call him and tell him this is not the standard, because we have a standard of management, so we have to follow standard of reporting. So atypical squamous cells of undetermined significance, this is kind of borderline. Most of the time it will be nothing. And then we have squamous cells, atypical squamous cells cannot rule out high grade. This is very serious, which is like a high grade. So always when you read, this is even for me and everybody, when you read atypical squamous, stop and read it again. Is it ASCAS or ASCH? One letter, but makes a big difference in the outcome and expectations. And then low grade, high grade squamous. This is squamous abnormalities. And then we have glandular abnormalities. And this is where تذكروا زمان كان في agus. Agus is not there anymore. If you see agus, call your cytologist. It's atypical glandular, could be NOS, not otherwise specified, or it could be atypical glandular fever endocervix or endometrium, or it could be atypical glandular fever neoplasia. طبعا, this one is the worst. This is also bad. But NOS is almost similar to ASCAS. Most of the time, you may not find anything with NOS. However, you should take it serious. But if you don't find anything, you don't worry about it. So just to review, we have we have squamous abnormalities and we have glandular abnormalities. This is standards of reporting in the pap smear report. This is just like what it corresponds to. When we talk about L cell, high grade, this is cytology, okay? So this is cytology and this is histopathology. This is pap smear and this is a biopsy, which is just what is it corresponding to. Okay, when we talk about CIN, we know that the virus goes from the cervice epithelium. This is cervice epithelium. It goes all the way to invade down to the basement membrane, and then it starts the oncogenic changes on the epithelium. So it goes down and then start changing the cells in the lower third. They call it CIN1, and then two-thirds it's called CIN2, and then full thickness, like this one, is a full thickness changes. So this is CIN3. You understand? So the effect of the virus, the oncogenic effect, does not start from the surface epithelium. However, it goes all the way down and then starts from the basement membrane going outward. When it's full thickness, this is CIN3. So this is just a frequency which we always forget the numbers. So don't worry about the numbers, but you should know, ask H. Atypical squamous cells cannot rule out high grade is almost similar to high grade, so you should take it very serious. Okay, when you have any abnormal pap smear, all the abnormal pap smear should be referred to colposcopy. For the exam, it's very easy. Any abnormal pap smear should be referred for colposcopy, with only one exception, ASCUS, because ASCUS is the only one carries another differential diagnosis. It could be chronic inflammation infection, it could be hypoestrogenemia, and that's why it's common in the perimenopausal age, or it could be dysplasia related to HPV. Okay, so differential diagnosis of ASCUS, chronic inflammation infection, or hypoestrogenemia in perimenopausal age, or atypical cells related to HPV. Now we were worried about atypical cells related to HPV, and that's it. And that's why you have three options to manage a patient with ASCUS. Either you do reflex. Hina, kelmat reflex HPV serotyping, meaning you did a pap smear, you got an ASCUS, and as a reflex of abnormal pap smear, you are doing HPV serotyping. That's why they call it reflex. Hinaka gunna isma ish? Co-testing. Co-testing lama na'milha ma ba'd. Hina, reflex is completely different. Or you can just repeat the pap smear in 4 to 6 months, or you can use local estrogen for 3 to 4 months again, and then you do repeat the pap smear. This one to rule out hypoestrogenemia, and this one to confirm or rule out the relation of your ASCUS to the HPV infection. طيب? Okay, before we move, is it clear so far? Any question؟ يا جماعة أسألوا، لا أحد يقول أنا R5 R4 ما أعرف، عيب كده قدام الباقيين. اليوم فرصة نسأل عن أي شيء، أي شيء ما أنتم عارفينه أسأله. ما في هنا أحد حيقول لك أنت R5 ولا R4، وكلكم R5 و R4 داخلين سوا. ما حد سؤال؟ واضح؟ السرعة كويسة؟ طيب، colposcopy. What is colposcopy? Colposcopy is an amplification of the cervix. It is just like amplifying the cervix times 10. It is a device where it's just like from outside, you put a dye to the cervix to identify where is the abnormal area to take a biopsy, so you convert your cytology into histology. That's why they call it colposcopy. Remember, all the patients with abnormal pap smear should be referred for colposcopy except ASCUS. So here, this is where the colposcopy. So when you have a patient where you see it's a normal cervix, but the pap smear is abnormal, this is where you need to do the colposcopy. You apply the acetic acid. Everybody should know the mechanism. Acetic acid will cause dehydration of the dysplastic cells. يعني cells اللي فيها dysplasia يصير لها dehydration, it becomes whitish. This is aceto white. They call it aceto white. So it affects or causes aceto white of the dehydrated cells because of the HPV changes. And then you can tell where to take the biopsy from here. You can take the biopsy from here. It could be dense, could be faint. كل ما كان dense أكتر, كل ما كان likelihood of severe dysplasia أكتر. Logel's iodine depends upon a principle where if you have a normal cells, the cytoplasm is full of collagen, okay? But if the dysplastic cells, if the cells is dysplastic, there will be no collagen. Normally, the color of Logel's iodine is the dusky brownish, right? When you apply it on a cervix and you don't have collagen inside, what happens, it will be faint. They call it mustard yellow. لونه زي المسترد حق الهوت دوغز, okay? So when you apply it here, all the cervix will take the dye except an area اللي هي dysplastic. It will be yellowish, like mustard yellow. So you can confirm there is an abnormal area here, so you can take the biopsy. So this is the dye we use, acetic acid and Logel's iodine. Dehydration of dysplastic cells, while this one will be not taken because of deficient of collagen. Okay? And then Monsil solution, this is ferric subsulfate. We use it for hemostasis if you have bleeding. Silver nitrate, again, we use it for hemostasis. So Monsils and silver nitrate, after the biopsy, you're going to take, you're going to use it for hemostasis, while this is an indicator where is the abnormal area, so you can take a biopsy. Okay, this is abnormal vessels. We know that cancerous and precancerous changes will cause neovascularization because it's high metabolic areas, needs a lot of oxygenation. So the body will react by creating new vessels. This is called mosaic form, okay? Mosaicism or mosaic. Low genial in mosaic, if you look from another angle, it will be punctation, which is like dots, just like punctation. So you can see this is an abnormal vessels where if you take a biopsy, it will be dysplasia, okay? And this is also an abnormal vessels when we apply what you call it green filter. So the green filter will exaggerate the abnormal blood vessels. The idea of using the green filter in colposcopy to exaggerate the abnormal vessels so you can see clearly the mosaic form and the punctation, which is called neovascularization. Okay, this is ECC and cervical biopsy. This is for cervical biopsy, and this is for endocervical cortage. قلنا متى نعمل endocervical cortage؟ لما يكون عندنا adeno endocervical abnormalities. You want to assess the endocervix. You're going to cure it, the endocervix for columnar cells. When you have an atypical glandular cells, you're going to cure it here. So you don't go beyond how many centimeters?
40.
Very good. And this is the biopsy from here. Okay, so this is abnormal pap smear, could be squamous, could be glandular. If it's a squamous, you're going to do colposcopy, you're going to take cervical biopsy because squamous is ectocervix. However, if it's a columnar or glandular, you're going to do colposcopy, but it is a must. You have to do endometrial biopsy and you have to do endocervical cortage. مرة مهمة النقطة هذه. It tells you, you know what you are talking about. Glandular abnormality, you do pap smear, you assess the ectocervix. In the same time, you do endometrial biopsy and atypical ECC because the glandular cells might be from the endometrium or it might be from the endocervix. مفهوم يا جماعة؟ طيب, very good. So now this is normal pap smear. We said this is basophilic, this is acidophilic, small nucleus. If you look here, you're going to see this is dysplastic cells increased in size. Maybe there is micronuclei. It's an uptake. So this is what you call it hyperchromatidism. And it's an indication of cervical dysplasia. This is even worse. You may say multiple mitosis. This is small nucleoli inside. You can see the small dots inside, right? So this is, you can tell it's dysplastic cells. And this is, I think, normal. And HPV vaccine. طيب, قبل ما نمشي كده, ما عشان نمشي بسرعة, في أشياء مفروض تكون سهلة وفي أشياء نتكي عليها. في سؤال الآن في الكولبوسكوبي وفي الديسبليزيا اللي قلنا عليها, أي سؤال؟ كله مفهوم؟ ولا كله ما هو مفهوم؟ طيب, HPV vaccine, we have the bivalent and the quadrivalent vaccine. Bivalent, we call it Cervarix. Quadrivalent, we call it Gardasil. And now we have quadrivalent, معناته it covers again is four strains of HIV, 16, 18, 6 and 11. Two oncogenic, two non-oncogenic. And we have the bivalent, which is the oncogenic 16, 18. And we have now Gardasil 9, which covers again its 9 strains of HPV. ما في أحسن وأسوأ, كل مين له ميزات له عيوب. However, everybody should know our recommendations بالنسبة للage, which is 9 to 26 for both. But we have an extended study which tells you it may benefit the patient up to the age of 45. It gives 100% immunogenicity again is 16, 18, as well as 6 and 11. However, it is recommended for 9 to 26. A regimen, everybody should know, it is زي الهيباتيتس بالنسبة لغارداسيل 0, 2 and 6. 0, 2 and 6 بالنسبة لغارداسيل. السيرفاليكس اللي هو bivalent 0, 1 and 6. There is no contraindication for the vaccine except pregnancy. Others, الكلام اللي في الميديا ويقولوا يسوي مش عارف ايه, كله ده كلام فاضي, كلها بس سوشيال ميديا بس او ميديا سوري. بس غير كده it's very safe, there is no contraindication, no complication, just minimal يعني side effects. But in general in pregnancy you cannot give it, and you can give it to any patient. Breastfeeding is okay. So is it safe? We know it's safe. If there is any serious side effect, there is none. Do we need to continue the screening? The answer is yes, because we know HPV, you have almost 100 strains affecting humans, and we are vaccinating you against only 4, so you still need the screening. So the screening is a must. A vaccination is not a replacement for the screening. And at the same time, Can we vaccinate patients with dysplasia? The answer is yes. Had a very common question. Leish, you have to tell the patient this is not a treatment. However, we know that the dysplasia or the virus is usually transient. If the patient cleared her body from the virus, she will be protected against reinfection. That's why you need to give it. This is the first reason. The second reason is very unlikely the patient is affected مع كل الأربع strains ولا كل التسعة. But at least she will protect herself against the others. But you should inform the patient this is not a treatment. هذا أهم شيء. يعني تقول لا تقول هذا not a treatment. It is recommended for boys. It is. في North America معظم ال provinces they do give it for the patients as boys. لأن the boys are the victors. Right? So it is recommended also for boys. Dosing regimen قلنا نعيده تاني ولا عرفتوا؟ 0, 2, and 6, 0, 1, and 6. Very easy. Okay, vaccination during pregnancy, lactation, as we said, pregnancy is okay, pregnancy is not, lactation is okay. And then, do we need a booster up to now, من 2008 نزل الفاكسين? We don't need a booster. We don't know the future, but up to now, we don't need a booster. Okay, so this is just to show, I like this slide because it was given to me by Johnson & Johnson, الشركة حقت الفاكسين. So as we said before, the virus will go all the way down to the basement membrane and start the oncogenic effect. Let me check if it works. So you can see it goes down all the way and then it starts the, oncogenic cervical dysplasia, lower third CIN1, two thirds CIN2, and then full thickness CIN3. And then if you don't treat, it will start the invasion below the basement membrane. مفهوم يا جماعة؟ Okay, so the vaccine usually, it gives what you call it neutralizing antibodies. Okay, so neutralizing antibodies will bind to the virus to prevent the oncogenic effect. And that's why you should give it, and if the patient is immune, once exposed to the virus, it will neutralize the virus before it causes any oncogenic changes. Remember, بس هذا السلايد أنا أجيبها دائما لأنه you can tell الناس تقلق دائما about smoking, lung cancer, مش عارف ايه. But if you can see here, the relative risk of HPV with cervical cancer is more than 500-fold. So it's huge. يعني الكانسر caused by HPV, احنا زمان كنا نقول 80%, بعدين صرنا نقول 90%, الآن almost, I would say 100, بس احنا عشان قدام الpatients نقول 99% related to HPV. Unless the patient got small cell carcinoma or other very rare variants. Okay, thank you. Any question? Good.
When to repeat the vaccine?
It's up to now, we don't need a booster, so we assume you know, you don't need to repeat it. Up to now. But هذه الأشياء طبعاً may change. Yes, في سؤال تاني؟ Very good. Because co-testing will give you a confidence that she is negative for HPV and HPV changes. So you do it every 5 years. لا الريفلكس انت عملتيه كده بالعربي جاكي بيشنت جاها اسكس فيو دونت نو ايش از ريليتد اسكس ريليتد تو اتش بي في اور نوت فبنعمله اذا طلع نيجاتيف يو سند ذا بيشنت باك فور روتين سكريننج افري 3 ييرز لو طلع بوزيتيف ات مينز يو نيد تو ريفير ذا بيشنت فور كولبوسكوبي مفهوم فديس از ذا ريزن واي يو ار دوينج ريفلكس تيستينج سؤال ثاني هناخد كده 2 minutes talk about management of cervical dysplasia so patient she got a dysplasia what's next what are the different tests we can do okay we should know whatever you do for the patient you should carry 90% cure rate so very easy very simple very effective treatment whether you do cryo or you do CO2 laser or you do a LEAP. LEAP means loop electrosurgical excisional procedure. LEAP cone. Or you do cold knife cone. يعني هدول الاثنين كلهم يعتبروا cone. ماشي؟ وفي CO2 laser كمان cone. So whatever you do, you have 90% cure rate. This is what you need to counsel the patient. However, if you have a young patient who wants to get pregnant, ideally, I wouldn't go for an aggressive treatment like cold knife cone because the risk of stenosis, whatever, is 3 to 5%. However, LEAP would be the best because it gives you a tissue diagnosis and at the same time, confirmation of a diagnosis. Like in CO2 laser ablation, cryo, ما عندكم biopsy if I don't know exactly what you are talking about. In general, you have to have a satisfactory colposcopy. لما تقولوا كساتيسفاكتوري colposcopy, it means you see the entire abnormal area and you see entirely the transformation zone. البيوبسي for sure it should be CIN 2 or 3. اللي بيصير هنا في البرايفت ويقول لك سوي على طول كده, I don't think this is the right way. You don't need to do anything for a patient with CIN 1 because the risk or likelihood of cure is almost 70%, especially in a young patient. But CIN 2, CIN 3, you need to do excisional procedure. Negative endocervical curtage, you have to do an endocervical curtage to make sure there is nothing inside the endocervix before you do the cryo, before you do the CO2 laser. Okay? So, cryo, we know that it's the mostly commonly used. You don't need a special training. Very easy, very safe, very. And again, it carries, as we said before, it carries 90% cure rate. And you can use freon, or you can use carbon dioxide, or you can nitrous oxide. It depends upon the center. You don't need to waste lots of time, but you have to know that it is accessible, it's easy, very effective, and you have to know what is the aftercare of the cryo. I'm going to give you all the lectures, by the way. This is cryo. You just put it for a few seconds till you have the wheel around it, and then you can stop it. You tell the patient a few days after. Remember that you'll have some discharge, which is related to the watery discharge, you can see, for up to 2 weeks. Very rare complications, very safe. It's very effective, as I said, almost 90% cure rate, inshallah. Okay, CO2 laser is very aggressive. You have to be very cautious when you do it, especially the anesthetist, if you have anesthesia on the other side. And again, you can use the CO2 laser as CO2 laser ablation, or you can use it as CO2 laser conization. It needs an extra, what you call it, extra skills. However, remember, you have to do ECC, endocervical curtage. لأن أنت بتعمل evaporation وما عندك tissue diagnosis. فقبل ما تعمل cervical evaporation, you have to do an ECC. Okay, technique, you don't have to worry about the technique or the power. In general, contraindication, inability to visualize the area. So it means if the dysplasia مع الأسيتو white extending laterally, try to avoid it because you will not be able to reach there. If there is cancer, for sure it is contraindicated, and it needs a very good special skills and for handling. Cervical conization, as we said before, we can use cold knife, you can use electrocautery, what we call it LEAP, loop electrosurgical excisional procedure. You can use CO2 laser conization. As we said before, with the cone, you're going to remove around 2 by 2 centimeters of the lesion. You're going to remove part of the endocervix and part of the ectocervix. عشان كده نعمل ECC. We call it post-cone ECC to assist the area هادي عشان نعرف هل فيها dysplasia أو لا. لأنه هذه واحدة من predictors of a cure. You have to do post-cone ECC. وحسب الفوليوم حق السيرفيكس, you can decide. You can go very lateral هنا. هنا small and small volume. هنا wide because it's a big or large bulky cervix. Okay. Cold knife again. As I said before, it needs special skills. I would leave it for perimenopausal. يعني مو perimenopausal. Beyond the age of 40, 45. If there is no fertility preservation issues, you can do it. And this is what we do with Sturm-Dorf. This is the best suture. Everybody should know. At the general gynae, by the way, you can do cone biopsy. You don't need to be a gyne-oncologist. But everybody should know how to do the Sturm-Dorf. It's a very good hemostatic sutures. بعدين نتكلم عليها. Very good. Everybody should know how to do it. Okay. Vasoactive, somebody, always we use vasopressin or anything. Moncel solution, remember, ferric subsulfate for hemostasis, it decreases the blood loss perioperative. This is the loop or LEAP. This is the machine. And when we use the cautery, electrocautery, we mix coagulation with cutting. So it we call it blend. Blend, meaning you're blending coagulation and cutting. This is the loop. You don't need to have lots of experience with that, but you have to be very cautious because if you don't, and I always tell my assistant to look at the loop at the sides because sometimes you get excited and the loop may invade the vaginal wall and it's very, very aggressive. If it goes lateral, يعني you will be in a big to-do. Okay, CO2 laser cone, don't worry about it. This is how it looks like. Needs a special training and skills. And honestly, I've never seen it. عشان كده, I don't think anybody does it. And then we have Ahmed Ghazi قال في سنغافورة يسووا دائما يسووا CO2 laser cone. Post-procedure instruction, very important to avoid anything vaginal. You avoid intercourse, you avoid tampon, you avoid anything inside for 4 to 6 weeks, and you tell the patient she may have some spotting or bleeding up to 6 weeks. Complications, bleeding, perforation, and bleeding could be early or it could be after 2 weeks. A delayed usually with the leap because of the dislodgement of the scar. And always remember, late complications like cervical incompetence or stenosis is very low, but it is roughly 5%. Just remember this number, 5%, okay? But with a cold knife, it's a bit higher, but this is usually what we quote the patient for. Okay, which method to choose? It depends upon the operator, it depends upon the center, and it depends upon the patient herself, age, fertility preservation potential. This is what tells you which one to use. But by the end of the day, you remember, 90% cure rate. Type, any sual? Yeah, sure, go ahead. Yes. Yes. See, what we do, we give, there is no recommendations, you can just continue. أنا عندي مريضة على أسكس وسي عين 1 من يوم ما جيت. يعني الآن لها 13 سنة. But you should, what I do here, we offer the patient after 2 years of persistent CIN, I tell the patient there is an option if you want to do a leap or a cone. You should know this is not mandatory, but it's an option. بس مو أول ما تجيك المريضة خصوصا في اليونج بيشنتس على طول تروح تسوي لها كون أو ليب، فهمت قصدي كيف؟ يعني بعد سنتين هنا عندنا سوشيالي وكل الوضع يعني صعب على المريضة تجيكي كل 6 شهور تعمل كولبوسكوبي لأنه مع الوقت حيطفشوا. فبعد سنتين I offer the patient but you have to tell the patient it is not a must, it's an option. فاهمين كيف؟
لو كانت
immunosuppressed a likelihood of progression into CIN 2 or 3 is higher. So it makes it more يعني indicated انك you offer the patient CIN 2 or 3. اوكي جماعه سؤال ثاني.
طيب